They are going over that surveillance tape at this point. And that eighth victim, by the way, a 15-year-old boy shot in the leg. They released the information to us just a little while ago. The witnesses tell us of a scene of mayhem out here. Folks running for cover, gunshots everywhere. And when the shooting stopped, it was pretty easy to tell who the victims were. John and Kathy Forner were on Canal Street when the shots were fired. The tourists were in town from California.
It was very surreal. I still can't process it. I'm having a hard time.
She's having a hard time with it.
They were walking to their hotel after a day at the French Quarter Festival.
We heard shots. We didn't know. It sounded like firecrackers. And we saw people scattering, so we ran in there.
From the witnesses we've talked to, there was an altercation that started inside of that McDonald's and came outside. Apparently two guys, one shooting at the other. It lasted about a third of a block, bullets flying everywhere, eventually ending at that tourist information booth. Police tell us they're still checking surveillance tapes from local businesses to try and identify the shooter or shooters. So far, no arrests have been made.
One woman was shot in the left shoulder. It was a through and through. And then there was a young man that was on the ground, and he kept saying he was shot, but he wasn't shot. There was no blood.
Guys, y'all need a map of the city? Free map of the city?
Deborah Lozana was out in front of her store working Saturday night, just like today.
He could have killed everybody.
Lozana says the shooter or shooters looked like kids to her, but she still wants them punished like adults.
I think they need to put him under the jail when they find him. Who in their right mind opens fire on total strangers on a busy sidewalk with a semi-automatic weapon?
Police say fortunately all of the victims did not suffer life-threatening injuries. For now, we're live on your side, downtown, Ken Jones, WDSU News.